All right, guys, if you struggle getting long and laid off at the top, so by that meaning the club head getting behind your hands and long at the top, maxing out your lead wrist flexion, maxing out the trail arm external rotation, what tends to happen is an early steepening in the downswing. And from there, you have to manage that by either changing your tilts or extending up through the golf ball to try and shallow the club. I'm going to show you today how to use the hanger from Watson Golf to steal a line from my buddy Shaheen Nagjivani to help independently shallow that club head early on in transition so you can maintain your proper tilts and rotate freely through the golf ball. So first off, show you how to set up the hanger. You can see I've got the club face of the hanger slightly open to my club face, 10 to 15 degrees open, okay? So when you get set up to the ball, what you're gonna find is that the hanger is gonna be closer to your trail arm than your lead arm, all right? So when we get set up to the ball, what we wanna do as we go back from to P2, or club parallel to the ground, we're gonna see that the hanger gains a little ground on our lead forearm, doesn't quite get all the way there yet. And then the next step, we're gonna vertically hinge, keeping that little bit of space between the hanger and our lead arm. From here, to get to the top of the backswing, we're just gonna max out the rotation. So now you can see that club head more in line with my hands, in a much better position to be able to shallow it early. This is where we're gonna get the independent shallowing. So from here, that space that we have, we're gonna close that gap by adding flexion in our lead wrist and also adding a little bit of ulnar deviation. So ulnar meaning we just go this way with our lead hand. So we're gonna now max out that flexion, gain a little bit of ulnar deviation, and then from here, we're gonna rotate through, keeping the hanger on your lead forearm till just post impact. So walk you through that again. We're gonna go back to club parallel to the ground, add some vertical hinge, max out the rotation of our body, and then from here, we're going to add flexion, ulnar deviation, so that club shallows, and then we're gonna rotate through. Hope this helps you get shallower early in the downswing so that you can maintain your tilts, rotate properly through the golf ball, and hit better golf shots.